Hi friends, my name is Phanindra. So in this video let us discuss about lichens. So normally these lichens was firstly introduced and theorized by Simon Schwenninder in 1867, and normally we know that lichens are mainly formed from algae and cyanobacteria, and we know that the cyanobacteria are also known as cyanophytes, which is commonly said to be as blue-green algae, because it is a Greek word where cyano indicates the color of blue, and bacteria we know about it, so it is commonly said to be as blue-green algae. And it is said to be as fungi because when compared to the symbiotic association, it will be compared with fungi, because normally this cyanobacteria has been arisen from the filaments of the fungi, and normally filaments of the algae, and normally these filaments are known as hyphae. And you know that hyphae will make up the body, and that body so called is known as mycelium. And I forgot to write here, these filaments are also known as hyphae, and these hyphae make up the body to form mycelium. And when compared to the symbiotic association, so normally symbiotic association takes place between algae and fungi, which mainly forms the lichens. So what is meant by this symbiotic association? Symbiotic association is nothing but mutualism which takes place between these algae and fungi. That's nothing but satisfaction takes place between these both algae and fungi. So benefits takes place between these algae and fungi in such a way that normally algae, it doesn't have proper shape of the body. You know, structure of that body is not proper. It is irregularly arranged. But it gets properly arranged with the help of fungi. In this way, it gets satisfied. It gets benefited. But in the case of fungi, it doesn't prepare its own food material because of the lack of chlorophyll. But if you see the case of plants, it consists of chlorophyll in such a way that it absorbs sunlight and it can prepare nutrition, right? So in this case of fungi, it doesn't consist of chlorophyll, right? So because of that chlorophyll, it cannot prepare its own food material, but it can prepare its own food material by the help of algae. So in this way, the both of this algae and fungi gets benefited. So that association and that mutualism is said to be a symbiotic association. Coming to the next one, it exhibits different properties. For example, if you see here, they are plant-like structures, but they are not plants, right? By this statement, you can understand that normally, if you see in the case of plants, it consists of roots and leaves. And leaves consist of chlorophyll, which absorbs sunlight, and water will be absorbed from the roots, where the process of photosynthesis as well as the synthesis of food takes place with the help of these roots and plants, roots and leaves of the plant. But in the case of this, you know, lichens, it cannot prepare its own food material, but it appears the structure of plant, right? That's only the meaning of the statement. They are plant-like structure, but they are not plants. Okay, so you can understand the statement further. I will explain to you later. So coming to the next, different types. There are different types of lichens, and they are among 20,000 of species which are present in our earth. And among them, four are very much important. They are Fruticos, Folios, Crustos, Lepros. Fruticos are tiny leafless branches, Folios are flat leaf-like structures, and Crustos are these lie on the surface of the peeling paint. You know, normally this appears upon the surface of a rock, and upon that rock, it appears like a peeling paint-like structure. For example, if you put a paint on a wall in such a way that it appears upon the wall. Lepros. These are powder-like structure. So now let us see how they appear, and let us see the structures of these Fruticos, Folios, Crustos, and Lepros. So this is known as Fruticos, which I have said to you, these are tiny leafless branches which will be arranged through the substrate, right? And coming to the second one, these are known as Folios. These are flat leaf-like structures which will be arranged in the bark regions of the tree. Coming to the third one, Crustos. These lie on the surface of peeling paint upon the rock. If you see here properly, it appears like a paint, right, upon the rock. So these are known as Crustos. Coming to the fourth one, Lepros. These are powder-like structures, you know, which appears upon the bark of the tree. And based on the growth, this lichens has been classified into two types, macrolichens and microlichens. So macrolichens ranges its growth from 1 to 2 millimeter in diameter. Coming to the microlichens, it ranges its growth from 0.5 millimeter to 0.5 meter per year, and here also per year. okay, based on the growth. Coming to the nomenclature is nothing but naming, right? So the name can be given for this, for the type of scientific name with genus and species. And here genus acts as reindeer and species acts as moss, and here species will be given with mosses means plural, and here singular we have to write because only one genus has been present before it, right? So here reindeer moss, island moss. In such a way the nomenclature will be given for a lichens. Coming to the next point, it produces its own nutrition with the help of a process known as photosynthesis. It is a biosynthetic pathway, you know. Normally, if you see in the case of plants, it consists of roots as well as leaves, and chlorophyll is mainly present within the chloroplast of the leaves, right? So with the help of this chlorophyll, it absorbs sunlight, and with the help of this root, it absorbs water in such a way that it mainly forms food material and it exhibits nutrition process. But here there is no roots or as there is no plants, but this can prepare only by itself own nutrition with the help of a process known as photosynthesis. But there are no roots or as no chlorophyll which are present upon these leaves of this, you know, lichens. Next one, these lichens grow upon the plants, and these lichens will be present on the substrate. Here substrate is nothing but, for example, walls, rocks, bark of tree. For example, normally the lichens which grows upon the bark of tree, and here the bark acts as substrate, and here lichens grows upon that substrate, so it is said to be as substrate. Substrate is nothing but surface area which helps in the growth of lichens. Next, this lichens you can see in sea level, I mean you can see in seas, tundra region and many environmental conditions, and you can also see it in rainforest regions and also in the temperate woodland regions, etc. In many regions you can find it. And coming to the next one, and the growth, the lichens grows in bark of tree, leaves, mosses, rocks, walls, roofs and gravestones, as well as also in the soil surfaces, etc. And next is gravestones are nothing but it is a special stone which has been found in graveyards. These are known as gravestones, and upon these gravestones you can find lichens. And 6 to 10% of lichens has been occupied in the earth, in the earthland region. In the earthland region, these lichens occupy 6 to 10% area. Okay, and these lichens has long lifespan. So now let us discuss about the importance of lichens. So coming to the first one, food. Soteria Icelandica, and commonly this is known as, I have said you before itself, wait, here if you see highland Iceland moss, this is a common name of that, you know, and this island moss normally helps in the production of the food material, and the food material will be used in the areas of Iceland as well as in the Sweden also. And next, this food also used in the tundra regions, which will be mainly consumed by the animals, and that food is said to be a stable food. So here food is nothing but which acts as lichens, and these lichens will be consumed by the animals in the tundra regions. Next, litmus paper. So before saying about the importance of this litmus paper, firstly you have to know what is meant by litmus paper. Litmus paper is nothing but which helps in the identification of pH value. For example, if you drop blood upon this litmus paper, 1 ml of blood upon this litmus paper, then it shows the range of the pH, the value of the pH. So that's nothing but the function of the litmus paper. And this litmus paper is mainly prepared by orsin. So orsin is a substance which has been abstracted from Rosella tinctoria. So Rosella tinctoria is a type of lichen which produces orsin, and this orsin helps in the helps in the preparation of the litmus paper, and this litmus paper mainly helps in the identification of pH value. Okay, coming to the third one, perfumes. And these lichens are also used in the preparation of perfumes, and incense is a liquid which has been scent which has been produced or is abstracted from Ramelina and Apimia. Here these both are known as lichens, and from these lichens incense or as the liquid has been abstracted or is produced, and this incense mainly helps in the preparation of perfumes. In the same way, here also the liquid or as incense which has been produced from Lobularia, Pulmonaria as well as Evemia, and there's nothing but both of these are same, and from these both incense will be abstracted, or the liquid will be abstracted, and the liquid will undergo some cycles within the tubes and helps in the preparation of perfumes. In this way, the perfumes will be prepared from the lichens. Coming to the medicines, another property, another importance is medicines. Arsenic acid, which has been abstracted from Arsenia and Cladonia. These both Arsenia and Cladonia are the type of lichens. Lichens which mainly helps in the production of arsenic acid. And this arsenic acid is mainly used for medicines. Like, it helps in the prevention of burns, and it can be applied upon the wounds. Okay, and it also helps in the maintaining of the air pollution. Normally, it increases the air pollution when normally, if you see in the case of these lichens, when the content of these lichens get decreases, then SO2 increases, sodium dioxide gets increases, and sodium dioxide is a toxic gas which is very harmful for the environment. So if the content of the lichens get decreases, if you see this arrow mark indicates decrease in lichens. So this decrease in lichens mainly helps, or else it increases air pollution, SO2. So SO2 increases with the decrease in lichens. So coming to the sixth one, fires. And Arsenia is a type of lichens which produces the forest fires. So forest fires are nothing but wildfires, and that fire will be produced, which depends upon the vegetation. Coming to the seventh one, fodder. And that fodder will be used by reindeers and cattle. And coming to the eighth one, industries, alcohols and tannins, preparation of alcohols and tannins. And here tannins, you know about alcohols, right? And tannins. So here tannins are nothing but, these are yellow brownish in color, and it is very bitter in taste. And also in some type of drugs, it also helps in the preparation of some types of drugs. So these are the importance of lichens. So thank you for watching this video, guys. If you like this video, please do like and subscribe. And if you have any doubts regarding this video, please comment in the comment box. And you can also join us in WhatsApp group, and the link of that invite link will be given in the description box. So if you are interested, you can also join.